You'll notice your bag's a little bit bigger than mine, but you gotta remember it's not the size, it's how you use it, so. Alrighty, what is it you do?
In education, 30 years, work at primary schools, and I'm a head teacher.
That's how you got into CrossFit.
Okay. I wouldn't have gotten into CrossFit if it hadn't been for my daughter. Ruthie had some experience of CrossFit when she came home for a brief period, and sought out a CrossFit, and as she does, thought it might be a nice idea for
just
me to
drag you in. Whenever you started here, you were doing a lot of running, you still do some running. How do you use CrossFit in your daily life?
I think running was my first love, and it's something I've always continued with. Certainly in the latter part of the races that I've been involved in since coming to CrossFit, I have felt stronger, particularly in hill races. I've noticed a huge difference.
Just that ability to push on up the hill.
Yeah, and feel more comfortable.
Still. If you could only do one exercise for the rest of your life, what would it be?
Not particularly good. Learn and love the weights.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. Is that a change?
Yes. I never used weights before. But I would like to improve and get better and get comfortable.
Okay.
That was one of the big challenges for me. That's something I found interesting and difficult and frustrating, in that I haven't been taught for 30 years.
Yeah.
Because I've only been in a position where I've been managing other people and actually haven't taken instruction.
Okay.
And that process of sequencing information and retaining the information and getting it in order has been, it's been challenging but really rewarding. I suppose, and I've been reading some of the rationale and the aims and objectives around CrossFit, and one of the things that it keeps cropping up is functionality.
Mm-hmm.
And they talk about actually improving across, not within a gym setting, but within your daily life and the things that you do in life.
Yeah.
Actually getting that sense of building capacity in other areas, that when you go out and you have a stress, you're dealing with stress, or dealing with individuals, or dealing with the public, or dealing with 4-year-olds, actually having greater capacity and stamina to do that.
And if there was an exercise from CrossFit that you could avoid doing for the rest of your life, what would that be?
Can I name a machine?
Yeah, sure.
You should label the machines. And I would stick a big BP on that bike. Vomit possibility.
What would you say to someone who's thinking about starting this?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Recommend it. It's not like any other gym experience I've ever had. And probably like a lot of people of my age, mid-50s, we've tried the old traditional unscripted leisure centre gym work,
sure,
which doesn't work.
Yeah.
Because you go for a little while, you hurt yourself, you don't enjoy it, there's no camaraderie, there's no friendship, there's no motivation, and there's no coach there to keep you right, get the best out of you. CrossFit's, you're there and you're in a small group situation, you have people around you who are supportive, and you have someone who has a degree of knowledge and expertise who can point you in the right direction and motivate you and keep you right. You did something with a group session that we were with, and it was weights, and you actually changed mid-session. It wasn't working for me, and you changed your approach completely. And you came along and you said to me something that I would say to a 4, 5, 6, 7-year-old, and you came along and you said, no, let's do Simon Says. And we basically copied you step, until actually we were comfortable, and then you moved on, and you went to the other group. And again, that's the thing I love, it's the scalability in this place, where you have somebody else with more reputations, more weight, and at a much higher skill level, they're working alongside us,
yeah,
and you can go between the two,
yeah,
which is what you did that night.